This tutorial is sponsored by GraphicStock.com. GraphicStock is a subscription-based service offering unlimited downloads of over 300,000 royalty-free graphics, photos, vectors, and more that you can use and keep forever. For only $39, you get 6 months of unlimited downloads. That's an 87% saving exclusive for new members during their April Creative Community Appreciation Month. To get this huge discount, click the GraphicStock link in my video's description below the title of this video. Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily create a comic book style cartoon from a photo. This is an update of a tutorial I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. I downloaded this great high resolution photo from GraphicStock.com. Once your photo is opened in Photoshop, the first step is to crop it to a specific height and resolution. To do this, open your crop tool and click Width, Height, and Resolution. Keep the width empty. If you see an amount in the width field, highlight it and press your delete key. For the height, type in 870 pixels. For the resolution, type in 150 pixels per inch. The reason we're using this height and resolution is because it'll ensure that the filters you'll be using will have the same results as mine. Go to the top of the bounding box and drag it down to where you'd like your image to be cropped. Repeat this on the bottom and sides until you're happy with the way your image is framed. Then, click the check mark at the top. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, we'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as allow us to change or adjust the effects that we'll be adding to it. Smart objects also allow us to replace our image with another without having to redo any of the effects. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. To lighten dark areas, go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. The shadows amount defaults to 35%, however, drag the slider to an amount that brings out just the right amount of details in your shadows. Then click OK. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click the eyeball icon next to the copy to temporarily hide the layer. Click the thumbnail of the bottom layer to make it active, and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Poster Edges. I'll make the Edge Thickness 2, the Edge Intensity 1, and the Posterization 2. However, feel free to experiment with these amounts. Remember, you can always change them later since it's a smart filter. Click the FX icon and click Stroke. Make the size 35 pixels and the position inside. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the color is white. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the color is black. The source is edge, the choke is 100%, and the size is 36 pixels. Then click OK. Click back on the eyeball icon to make the top layer visible and click its thumbnail to make it active. Go to Filter, Pixelate, and Color Halftone. make the radius 6 pixels, and keep all the screen angles at their default amounts. Then click OK. Change its blend mode to soft light. Lastly, we'll make the colors pop a bit more. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Vibrance. Drag the Vibrance slider all the way to the right. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.